Our topic is about greatest common factor and least common multiple. Yes. But before we proceed with our lesson, I'm going to give you an example on how to find the factor and the multiple. Syempre, dapat alam natin ang pagkakaiba ng dalawa. Ayan. So, kasi minsan, nagkakaroon tayo ng misconception about sa multiple and factor, o minsan hindi natin alam ano nga ba yung multiple and yung factor. So, magbibigay ako ng example. So, dito meron tayong 12. Yes. Itong 12 na to, kukunan natin ng multiples. Kapag sinabi natin multiples, ganito yan. Okay? So, syempre magsisimula tayo sa pinaka number itself. And then 24. Okay? And then followed by 36. Okay, and then we have here now 48 and so on. Okay, walang iniwan yan sa 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay, ibig sabihin yung 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 multiples ng 3, and then yung 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 ay multiples ng 2. Okay, so that is multiples. So, pag sinabi naman natin na factors, ano yung factors ng 12? Ang 12 ay may factors na. Ayan. Siyempre, number itself. Okay? And then, factor yun ng 12 yung 6, yung 4, yung 3, yung 2, at siyempre, ang factor ng lahat, 1. Yes, kasi itong mga numbers na to, kapag ginamit mo siya as divisor at dinivide mo yung 12 sa kahit alin sa isa sa kanila, for sure, walang remainder. So, ibig sabihin, magkakaroon tayo ng exact quotient. Okay? So, yun ang pagkakaintindi ko sa factors at yun yung lagi kong tinatandaan para hindi ko siya nakakalimutan. So, mag-proceed naman tayo sa greatest common factor at sa least common multiple. Gagamitan naman natin siya ng prime factorization. So, kung may knowledge naman tayo sa divisibility, at alam kong meron kayong knowledge kasi nai-explain ko yan sa mga previous video ko, alam nyo kung paano yung divisibility rule at alam nyo kung ano yung divisibility rule. So, yun ang i-apply natin dito. Pero, syempre, gagamit lang tayo ng mga simpleng halimbawa. Halimbawa, we have 12 and 42. So, alamin natin yung greatest common factor niya and least common multiple through prime factorization. So, syempre, applyan natin ang divisibility rule. Mag-start tayo dun sa pinakamababang prime number na pwede natin gawing divisor nitong mga ito. Okay, so magsisimula tayo sa 12. So, alam naman natin na ang 12 ay even number. At alam natin na kapag ang number ay even, alam natin madidivide sa 2 yan. Okay? So, 12 divided by 2, alam natin na 6 yan. At alam din natin na ang 6 ay even number pa din. Therefore, alam natin na madidivide mo yan sa 2. So, 6 divided by 2, we have 3. So, isusulat ko na lang dito yung pinakamataas na factor sa umpisa. Pero kayo, bahala kayo kung paano nyo siyang paraan ayusin. But for me, ganito ko siya ayusin. Okay, so now, dito naman tayo sa 42. So, alam natin na ang 42 ay even number. At dahil even number yan, alam mong madidivide mo yan sa 2. Okay? So, 42 divided by 2 is 21. Si 21, alam mong hindi mo na yan madidivide sa 2 dahil odd number yan. Pero, madidivide mo siya sa 3. Kasi 2 plus 1 is 3. At we all know, based on the divisibility rule, na kapag ang sum ng digits ay divisible sa 3, ibig sabihin divisible siya sa 3. So, 21 divided by 3, we have 7. Okay? So, lalagay ko na lang yung pinakamataas na factor dito sa unahan. 7 times 3 and then times 2. Okay? So, for future use, gagawin ko ay kukopihin ko yan. Okay, lalagay natin dito. Yan. So, ang greatest common factor niyan, of course, kukunin mo yung mga number na may common sa kanila o yung factors na common sa kanila. Katulad na may common silang factor na 3 at may common silang factor na 2. So, ika-count mo yan as isang 3 na lang at saka isang 2. Okay? So, yun lang. Ang gagawin mo lang, yung common sa kanilang dalawa, kung merong more than 1, okay, kukunin mo yung product. So 3 times 2, we have 6. So therefore, the greatest common factor of 12 and 42 is 6. Okay, dito naman tayo sa least common multiple. And same pa rin ang gagawin natin. Okay, bibilugan mo yung common factor at ika-count mo siyang isa. Okay, so hindi lang katulad kanina na sila lang yung minultiply mo. Dito, maski yung walang common or yung numbers na walang common, hindi common sa kanilang dalawa, ay isasama mo and kukunin mo yung kanilang product. Okay, so gamit na lang tayo ng calculus 7k times 3 times 2 times 2, that is equal to 84. Okay, so we have 84. It means that the least common multiple of 12 and 42 is 84. Okay, let's proceed with our next example. So now let us find the greatest common factor of and least common multiple of 9, 12, and 30. So dito tayo. So we all know that 9 is divisible by 3. Yes, kasi 9 is equal to 3 times 3. Ayan, 9 divided by 3 is 3. Yes, so dito naman tayo sa 12. Yung 12, although maliit lang naman siyang number, siguro pwede na lang natin gayahin yung example kanina. The 12 is equivalent to 3 times 2 times 2. So ilagay na lang natin dito sa 3 times 2 times 2. Okay, for number 30, we all know that 30 is divisible by 2. And it's also divisible by 10. Yes, pero sa 2 na lang tayo. Okay, so 30 divided by 2 is 15. 15 is not divisible by 2 since hindi siya even number. Pero divisible siya sa 3. Kasi, yan, 15 divided by 3 is 5. Okay, so we have here now 5 times 3 times 2. Okay, ilagay na lang natin yung mataas na number dito sa unahan. 5 times 3 times 2. So dito, meron lamang tayong isang factor sa prime factorization na common. The rest, hindi na. So, it means that ang greatest common factor lang natin dito ay 3. Okay? Lagyan natin to ng label, greatest common factor. Sa least common multiple naman, ayan, katulad lang din ng ginawa kanina, may common sila, pero this time, kikilalanin mo rin yung ibang common. Since, halimbawa, katulad nito, gawin mo yan 2, and then you have your 3, and then, ikukunin mo yung product nilang lahat. So, we have your 5 times 3 times 3 times 2 times 2. Check natin kung tama. 5, this is 30. So, 5 times 3 times 3 times the times 2. So, let us use calculator. So, we have your 5 times 3 times 3 times 2 times 2. So, we have here now 180. So, it means that, okay, the least common multiple of, okay, 9, 12, and 30 is 180.